Spearfishing. For 4 weeks, while island hopping through the Torres Strait Islands is my kind of adventure. And also for my spearfishing mates, Jack, Rick, and Elliot. My name is Dennis, and I will be going home with my mates to visit my friends and family and show the guys around. Over the last month, we've got together to cover these main things: safety, equipment, and training. We all know the basics of how to dive safely from training and courses, but sometimes, no matter the effort, faults happen, putting your friends at risk. Every year, divers around the world experience shallow water blackouts. Sadly, those who dive alone don't get rescued.
Jack! Jack, come on, man! Come on!
Spearfishing is rewarding in many ways, but spearos face risks and dangers every time they leave land.
Shot a rainbow run up a burley. I strung it so the spear was on the other side of the fish and it was on the line. I started pulling it up and the shark kind of had a go and I just got it out of his way because I can't go up or down quick. Just turned around in time to see sharks just tore the fish apart. And then my shooting line was around my right foot and just going, I'll just untangle this and let it go. And said the same thing back on the boat. That could have got messy. I was like, yeah.
Unfortunately, most spearos have experienced their own version of this.
So yeah, I dove down, hit the reef at 16 meters, flicked over to my right, saw a tusky just cruising in, slowly bring the gun over, saw this little piece of coral sticking up, figured I'd ambush it right over that corner. When I popped over, he'd already gone over the other side of the bommy. I basically just tucked back down, started scratching, hoping he'd turn around. Turned around, as soon as he turned to the side, got a nice shot through the gill plate. Instantly holed up on the other side. Knew that I wasn't gonna get the fish out. Just went straight up. Unfortunately though, right as I hit the surface, nobody was watching me.
No one watched me. Hey man, if you dive, I always watch you. When you come up, follow me, wait for me to dive. Don't swim off, I don't want to like chase you.
Sorry.
The way I normally dive is I do one up, one down, and I'm so used to doing it. I probably should have had that talk with him before we started diving. I take part of the responsibility for not making sure that we are diving safe. I know that if we ever dive together again, we'll definitely be a lot safer.
Resources are limited in the Torres Strait, so we saw the guys at the spearfishing superstore in Cairns to supply us with gear for the trip. Some new spear guns and a heap of spares were needed.
So just picking up my new Rife, the Blue Water Elite. Got a 10mm closed track, slip tip, 4 bands, 2 Ocean Hunter floats, and a breakaway system. Puts a bit of hurt on them.
80 centimeter Rabitec carbon roller with a compact roller head, micro ball rubbers, Savamar Voodoo reel with Dyneema shooting line.
Thanks to Superstore for hooking us up with the big Blue Water Rife. Hopefully we get some good fish up in the Torres Straits.
To test our spearfishing and camping equipment, we did an overnight trip to the Franklin Islands to ensure we had the essentials and everything worked well.
So the purpose of this weekend was to get a camping day in, try our new tents and check out that we've got everything that we need. And I think we've already established a couple of small things that we could improve already. I bought a small mattress and I think I'm gonna upgrade.
My gun that I cut down, I forgot to plug, so filled with water. It was like trying to hold up a 165 Woody in the water. So yeah, got the tent set up, got the mattresses set up, collected some firewood. Chef Elliot started prepping all the trout, filleted it, marinated it, barbecued it, and had some nice trout sandwiches for dinner.
It was just curry fish in bread, bit of mayo and a bit of lettuce, wouldn't have gone astray.
And it was delicious.
Had a good night with the boys.
Yeah, had a really nice romantic atmosphere.
Up nice and early this morning, got all our stuff packed up, the boat ready, sitting there waiting to go.
Weather looks like it's dropping a little bit.
Yeah.
Head out to the reef, have a look at some spots out there. That's in close. Got a couple of hours to check out and see what we can get. for now, I think we'll probably stop talking, go shoot some stuff.
With all the training we have done together over the last month, hunting as a team has showed how valuable it is for safety and landing good fish.
Dennis jumps in no more than 5 seconds later, comes up, screams.
As I looked over to the right, I could just see this mackerel rolling in. I didn't have time to put two bands on, so I just loaded one.
Goes down, punches a mackerel, and I'm just like, all right, sweet. Off to a good day.
We'd had these jobbies coming up on the burley for probably the better half of the first day, evading us and darting off. Dropped down on this one and
bombed him.
Yeah, straight bombed him. So it was a pretty quick dive. Was going for a shot, didn't end up taking it. Actually shot it from above, pinned it straight through from the top down the side of one fillet, but had to get off a quick shot. So I just got straight on that line and just pulled it in as quickly as I could. I felt pretty confident that we'd get it in and yeah, boated the first fish of the day.
The lead up over the last month has been a great start with learning points and some good memories shared. Before going on the trip, we shipped most of our things up so that it would be there on arrival. The costs aren't cheap, and most islanders have little choice when it comes to getting anything to them. Most of our preparation is done. The time has now come for us to make our way to the Torres Straits and start our epic journey. We are all looking forward to exploring all regions and meeting anyone who is around. Stay tuned with our posts on Facebook and Instagram while we capture the great moments to share once our trip has ended through a number of episodes. Well, I hope you like this episode, and hopefully we'll get some good footage for you up in the Torres Straits in the weeks to come.